Tusk to Earth. Oh, it's you. I thought you were dead. Anyway, just a few more parts to find and you can join us. There are probably other people with you down there. They must have some information. My father's tests scattered debris all over the area. Now, I'll start looking for an energy source powerful enough to get the rocket off the ground. Won't need much, 20,000 watts and we'll be good. I'm in contact with one of the foolhardy ones back on Earth. Let's call him Mr. X. He assures me he has a solution. So hunt down the rocket parts and protect your rocket pad from wild zombies. I'll take care of the power needed for launch.
You there. Come here. I'm Annie, the nurse here at Paradize. My patient has just disappeared. I barely had the time to get my saw out, let alone start work with it. She needs to be found before she gets in any trouble. She's in a wheelchair and she's mute. If a zombie sees her, she can't run or shout for help. Hurry! The same. My amputation research can't afford these types of delays. By the way, if you get a boo-boo, feel free to treat it yourself. Take these plans for building a kitchen. You can use it to create medicine, tonics, ointments. Don't come here unless you need my saw. Thank you.
Howdy, tourist. I'm looking into a tale they tell of these parts. Interested? They say that before they started firing rockets around here, the soil was all kinds of fertile. There's even supposed to be a tomato plant somewhere here from back then. They say the Paradize folks were protecting it. When the power broke in their camps, the zombies stayed. I think you know where I'm going with this. How about you clean up those pylons and get that tomato? Well, split the seeds with your 50-50. Nice butchering, tourist. I heard the fight from over here. Well, here's half of the seeds, just like I promised. Oh, Papa, let's we come back now.
You're looking for rocket parts? Haven't seen any, but it's been a while since I was in the forest. My buddies are in the city, northeast of here. They may know more than I do, and it's good timing, actually. Mac Fixer, Ignacio, and I are leaving Paradize soon. Some crazy woman trying to steal our tech, take control of the whole region. And we also want to test our hacking on a larger scale. Mac and Ignacio went out to get some things we need, but I haven't heard from them in a while. Could you go and find them?
Thank you very much. I'm Ignacio. I see you got one of Bob's portable pylons. Did he send you? I had to hide here to escape one of our rivals, Ivy Uppersmith. She's trying to steal our technology so she can conquer the world. She didn't see me, but this dang metal curtain won't open from the inside. Do you want to help me find Mac Fixer? I know where he is, but you seem to have a good relationship with the zombies. He's always tinkering with stuff he finds lying around, if you're looking to upgrade your tech. Okay, Nacio, don't panic. Think of your favorite movies. Think of Agent 770. That's right. You're with Agent 770. Nothing can happen to you. Okay, Nacio, don't panic. Ignacio. Thank you. Okay, Ignacio, don't...
Bob's Archives, C-87-5, the Snarling Maintenance Zombot. Open the camp pylon configuration menu. Add a Zombot. Give it a repair kit. Order it to use this while out of combat, and then activate the traps while in combat. And don't forget, this zombie hates it when people damage its stuff, and it has to fix everything.
Ivy Uppersmith is still hanging around. The less Mac and I are outside, the fewer problems we'll have. She doesn't know you, so she should leave you alone. Would you like to collect the things we need? You need to find food. The city is built around a huge shopping mall. You should be able to find what you need fairly easily. Come back and see me when you've finished. Please don't die.
Rocket parts? I can't even find motor parts, let alone jet engines. But I guess you could, Brains! Sorry. Maybe you could strip two or three cars around here to find the parts I need, and in return, I'll take a look in my stock. You never know. Thank you.
great! Thank you very much. We can now escape more quickly thanks to you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Perfect. With a bit of cardboard and a V8 half-piston, I should be able to build a makeshift clutch. As for your rocket part, I know who to talk to. By the time you've done a couple of jobs, I should have some news. He's watching us. I imagine he'll show himself when he's ready. He's not going to win the Soundest Mind of the Year award, if you know what I mean. Oh, enough! Oh, it's you who obeys me! It's... Oh, oh, brains! Brains! No! Stop! Sorry. Just having a small problem with an obstinate Zombot. We need it to transport what you helped us find, but my mind control technology is a bit buggy. The Zombot took the opportunity to cut and run. I can see through its eyes. If you're quick, you could catch it. I'll guide you. Going in the right direction. Keep going. We're almost there. Yeah, it's... Oh, brains! Brains! God, that's enough! Get out of my head!
No, not over there. Wait, where do you think you're going?
Hey, come back!
Perfect. I think I know what went wrong with the helmet. Two rolls of sticky tape and a drop of toothpaste should do it. All we need to do is pack up and get out of here. I spoke to my contact as promised. He doesn't trust you, but he's agreed to keep an eye on you. Don't worry, he'll show himself eventually. He's just got a few screws loose.
Wow! Thanks so much for finding them. I hope you find your rocket parts. I'll upgrade your portable pylon to give you a little help. Now you can have two Zombots.
Is that you? Have you seen the amount of wild zombies? We're being overrun. I think the fence is breached. But you're armed. Go and have a look. If there's a hole, plug it.
Ooh.